I stand with my brothers and sisters when I say Black Lives Matter. To speak out against the police brutality and systematic racism that allows for the mistreatment, the persecution, and murder of our Black people. And while the stories of George Floyd or Ahmaud Arbery still stings hard, the fact is there's thousands of violent incidents that happens to Black people that's not recorded, reported, or afforded the outrage it deserves. And it's important to note that our Black men are not just the targets of such hate, so is our Black women, such as Breonna Taylor, Sandra Bland, Shante Davis, and Kendra James. So, how can you get involved? You can push back against racism. Educate yourself on your own Black history or inherent bias, and support our racial justice organizations. Let's help share their message. It's important to create a world in which our children do not have to be afraid to walk an unfamiliar neighborhood, to buy a bag of Skittles, to shop in a mall, or to ask the police for help.
Today, I am telling all women, be strong, be what you are, for God is in your corner. We always think of ourselves as being somebody, but when I think of how, I always think of, suppose that had been me. Would I have got the recognition that he got? No, because I am a woman. And all of our things that police do to us, it's always pushed under the cover. You never hear about it maybe once or twice. And these are the things that we are fighting for. We need justice. We need it every day. So, Lord, just take us in your arms. Guide us in the right direction, for we are the women of today.
I'm gonna say that one more time.
He brought me through hard trials. He brought me through tribulations. Let a day go by and not realize it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. Back was against the wall, he looked out for me. He heard my cry and rescued me.
Blessed and highly guess the biggest thing was to hear George Floyd call for his dead mother. I think every woman in America felt that pain of your child calling out for you. As women, sometimes we don't always lift each other up. We don't stick together. And it's going to take for us to stick together that we can be heard. Say her name. Say her name. We are essential to the past, the present, and the future. I was told when I was born, I had two strikes against me. Two. One is being black and one is being female. If we don't stick together as black females, we will fail. We have got to stick together. We have got to bind together. And I just love this hashtag, say her name. Because we don't say each other's names. We don't uplift each other. We want to tear each other down for things that don't matter. We need to bind together and be strong. Be as one body and move as Christ moves. These are the things that are going to make a change in America for us black women. God bless you and keep you.
As I look back through the years,
don't you know that it's amazing?
It's amazing how he got me from the devil.
What the devil
meant for me.
Mixed with evil, but what did God do?
You got to call on Jesus and listen to the angels sing. Being a young mother, I knew there would be things I had to teach my son. I never could imagine that one of those things would be about racism. I had never experienced racism until a few months ago. Me and my son attended a protest in support of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor. While there were many people out there supporting Black lives, coming down the street, we were met with a few people who showed their hate towards us. People putting up finger signs, people yelling, "I hate Blacks," gave us pushback. I had to sit down and explain to my son that these were the people who I tried to warn him about. Trying to tell him that no matter how hard he works in school, in college, in life, to have the same qualifications as a white counterpart, that he would never be seen as equal as them because of the color of his skin. Since Breonna Taylor and Sandra Bland's story, I as well have become fearful of my safety. I am already a Black woman. Women are being looked at as inferior to males. So why am I being targeted because of the color of my skin? I've learned in these past few weeks that silence really is violence. Those who are not speaking up for Blacks are definitely looked at as being against Blacks. And we are demanding justice. No justice, no peace, no racist police.
Nobody have to tell me, but I know.